We want to graph the quadratic function h of t equals t squared plus 5t plus 4 using this online graphing tool. To use this tool, we first have to select the parabola graphing tool here, then click on the vertex, and then one other point on the parabola. But before we do this, let's work out some things by hand. The first thing we should recognize is that the given quadratic function is in general form, or the form given here, y equals ax squared plus bx plus c. When we have a quadratic function in this form here, we can find the vertex using these formulas here, where the x-coordinate is negative b divided by 2a. This also gives us the equation to the axis of symmetry, and then the y-coordinate is f of negative b divided by 2a. Notice how our quadratic function uses t instead of x, which doesn't make a difference, but if it's helpful, we could write the given function as y equals x squared plus 5x plus 4. This should produce the same graph. Notice a is 1, b is 5, and c is 4. So if we want to find the coordinates of the vertex, let's first find negative b divided by 2a. So x equals negative b, or negative 5, divided by 2 times 1, that's negative 5 halves. Or in decimal form, this would be negative 2.5. It might be more helpful to use the decimal value to graph on the coordinate plane. So let's give the x-coordinate as negative 2.5. And since this point is on the graph, to find the y-coordinate, we'll now substitute negative 2.5, or negative 5 halves, for x, which would give us y equals, let's use negative 5 halves squared plus 5 times negative 5 halves plus 4. Let's go ahead and evaluate this on the calculator. So we have negative 5 halves squared plus 5 times negative 5 halves plus 4. The decimal value is negative 2.25. To get the fraction value, we'll press math, enter, enter. So negative 9/4 for the y-coordinate, or if we want, negative 2.25. Now we still have to find one other point in order to graph the parabola accurately. So to find a second point, we can select any x value that we want, but usually we do want to select an x value that's close to the x-coordinate of the vertex to make sure the point does show up on the given coordinate plane. But looking at the quadratic function, let's let x equal 0. This makes the substitution very straightforward. Notice that y is equal to 0 squared plus 5 times 0 plus 4, so the y-coordinate is positive 4, which is also the y-intercept. Now before we graph this parabola though, notice that a is positive, which does mean the parabola will open up. So let's just make a note of that. Since a is positive, the parabola opens up, which means it will look something like this. So now to graph the parabola, we'll first plot the vertex, and then use this point here, the y-intercept, as our second point. So the vertex would be negative 2.5, negative 2.25, which would be somewhere in here. And then the second point is the y-intercept of 0, 4, which would be here. Now if we're doing this by hand, it's very helpful to sketch the axis of symmetry, which would be the vertical line passing through the vertex, which would be this vertical line here. Notice how the y-intercept is 2.5 units to the right of the axis of symmetry, which means there must be another point 2.5 units to the left, which would be this point here. So now we can sketch a nice parabola, and notice how it does open up. Now let's graph this using our online graphing tool. First we'll click on the parabola graphing tool, which is here. Next we'll click on the vertex, which was negative 2.5, negative 2.25. It's approximately here. And then the second point was the y-intercept of 0, 4, which is here. Let's go ahead and check it. And we graphed it correctly. Notice 10 out of 10. I hope you found this explanation helpful.